Hi friends, in this video we see control system questions asked in TRB 2017 in EEE branch. Already I posted part 1 of the few questions in part 1. Now it is remaining questions we will solve in this session. First question is, the total gain x4 by x1 of the signal flow graph shown in the figure. Very very simple question. They have given signal flow graph. What is that? It is like this, right? X1 and X4. Fine. So here they have given, it is A, this is point, right? This is B, this is C, and this is D, right? Now what we have to do, we have to minimize this graph. So up to this, no problem, A only. All three are in cascade. So here it is C. What about this area? This is feedback structure, but it is positive feedback. It is not negative feedback. So we know that for positive feedback, what is the simplified version? It is B divided by 1 minus BD, right? So that is giving A. So everything is cascade. So what multiplication? ABC divided by 1 minus BD. So what is my answer? Answer is option C, ABC divided by 1 minus BD. Clear? So why I have put a, we know the simple equation. If you are having, right, G of S and this is H of S minus or plus or minus, let us assume C of S, R of S, right? If you are having a block like this, what is the equivalent version? C of S divided by R of S equal to G of S divided by, yeah, if it is minus means it will be 1 plus, if it is plus means it will be minus, right? G of S, H of S, right? In our problem, instead of G of S, what we have? B. Instead of H of S, what we have? D, right? That's why. Next one. Select the wrong statement about the negative feedback closed loop system. So closed loop system will increase the stability in steady state. That is right statement, right? So this is right only. Because what about they ask? They ask about a wrong statement. This is right statement. It rejects any disturbance signal, that is also right. Right? Low sensitivity to parameter variation. Yes, of course, it will not vary if parameters are varying. That's all right. It increases the error signal. No, it will decrease the error signal. So this is the correct option, right? So negative feedback will decrease the error signal. Next. If unit step response of the network is 1 minus e power, it should be e power minus at, right? So 1 minus e power minus at, what is the step response? Sorry, impulse response. They have given step response. What they ask is impulse response. So impulse response is the differentiation of step response, right? So what is my step response? D by dt into 1 minus e power minus at, because it is a step response. So if we simplify, what do you get? Differentiation of 1, 0, minus e power minus at into minus a. So what I get, that is equal to e power at into a. So a into e power at, so e power minus at, right? So a into e power minus at. Option a is a right answer, right? So correct. So option a is the right answer, a into e power minus at. Next question. Yeah, feedback system with the characteristics equation 1 plus k into 1 by s into s plus 1 into s plus 2 is equal to 0. Which one is the actual breakaway point of root locus system? So whenever they give, they ask a breakaway point, we have some set of procedures we have to follow. What is that? First thing what we have to do is, first we know 1 plus g of s h of s equal to 0 is characteristics equation. In this characteristic equation, we have to write the equation in terms of k and differentiate k with respect to s. So what is my characteristic equation? 1 plus k into s plus 1 into s plus 2. This is, write this equation in terms of k. If you write like this, it will be k is equal to minus s into s plus 1 into s plus 2. This is equal to minus s into s squared plus 3s plus 2. That is equal to minus of s cube plus 3s squared plus 2s. This is my k. Now differentiate k with respect to s and equate to 0. This is next step. So it will be giving, what it will give? 3s squared plus 6s plus 2 is equal to 0. Right? So this one will give, if you simplify this, s1 is equal to minus 1.57. Sorry, s is equal to, we are having two roots. So one is s1, another one is s2. Let us assume that one will be minus 1.57 and another one is 0.422. So we got 2 points. Out of these 2 points, which is lying on the root locus diagram, we must know. Right? So for that, what you have to do? We have to draw pole zero plot. Where is the pole? We are having one pole at 0. Right, another pole at minus 1, third pole, let us assume P1, P2, third pole at minus 2. So 0, minus 1, minus 2. So in this diagram, we are having one pole at 0, another pole at minus 1, third pole at minus 2. Right, okay. Now we see we are having 2 points. One is at minus 1.57 and another one is minus 0.422. So one is at minus 1.57, another one is minus 0.422. Clear? Now we see we have to find the root locus branch, right? So if you find, we have to, where the root locus branch lies, if you see from which, from the pole you see right hand side, if the right side contains odd number of poles and zeros, then there is a root locus branch. Here you see, from here, if you see right side, we are having only one pole. So there is one branch. Here one root locus branch. But when you see from here, there are two poles, even number of poles. So there is no root locus branch. Right? Then if you see after, away from this, after this, from this side, you can see three poles. This is one, this two, and three poles. So here also there is one branch. Clear or not? So we are having two branches, right? So one branch is here, right? And another branch is here. We are having 2 points, minus 1.57 and minus 0.42. Minus 1.57 lies at this location, right? Whereas minus 0.422 lies here, right? So this point only lies in the root locus branch, whereas minus 1.57 doesn't lie in the root locus branch. So minus 0.42, yes, minus 0.422 is the answer, which is nothing but option B. Right, okay. Next question. Bode plot of the stable system is shown in the figure. What is the transfer function of the system? So they have given Bode plot. So from this, what we are understanding, this is talking about gain at 0 dB, gain at omega is equal to 0, right? It is omega. This point is omega 0, that is DC gain. This point is talking about minus 20 dB per decade. Minus 20 dB per decade means one pole, because each pole introduces minus 20 dB per decade. So we have one pole at this location. This is my DC gain because omega is equal to 0. Right, now we will solve the problem. So what should be my transfer function? G of s, we have only one pole. Numerator, I don't know. That DC gain we have to find. Denominator, we are having only one pole. That pole also, I don't know. Right? Okay. K by S by S into A. So, as per our problem, DC gain is 20 dB. DC gain 20 dB means, what is the meaning? How we will find DC gain normally? We substitute S is equal to J omega and make omega is equal to 0. S is equal to J omega. And substitute omega is equal to 0 to find DC gain. So, G of 0 only we are going to find. So, G of 0 is equal to 20 dB. So, my diagram, so first I write G of J omega, that is equal to K by J omega plus A. Now, I find G of 0. G of 0 is K by 0 plus A. That is equal to 20 dB. Right, so K by A is equal to 20 dB. K by A is equal to 20 dB. So now it is in decibel, I convert into number. So 20 dB means 20 log some factor is x is equal to 20 dB, right? This implies x is equal to 10. So K by A is equal to 20 dB. I converted 20 dB into simple number. If you are having any doubt in dB conversion, please refer my video on decibel. So K by A is equal to 10. This implies K is equal to 10A. What is our A? A is nothing but the pole we assume. Yes or no? This is simply a denominator. Denominator is talking about A is equal to pole because it is a form of K by S plus P. So from this option, you see all are having 10. So pole is at 10, right? So A is 10 for us. So we see that K by A is equal to 10. A is equal to 10. So K is equal to 10 into 10, 100. So then what is my equation, right? So we got it. I write here. I don't have space. So, as per my equation, G is equal to K, K found, I found was 10, divided by S plus A is 10. So, 100 by S plus 10. So, which option is correct option from the diagram? So, the option is 100 by S plus 10. So, option A is the right answer. Clear? So, very simple. 100 by S plus 10. Next question. Given the damping ratio is equal to 0.6, undamped natural frequency is 5 radian per second of the system. The peak time of the system is dash when subjected to unit step signal. So what they have given? They have given zeta is equal to 0.6 and omega n, that is undamped natural frequency, is 5 radian per second. These things they have given. What we have to find? Peak time, right? Peak time TP is given by pi by omega d. What is omega d? Omega d is equal to damped natural frequency, damped frequency, omega n, 1 minus zeta square. Omega n is equal to 5, root of zeta is equal to 0.6, 0.36, 0.6. So it is 0.64. It is 0.8. So 5 into 0.8, 4, right? So omega d is equal to 4. What is my TP? TP is equal to pi by omega d. Omega d is nothing but 4, right? So if you simplify, what do we get is 0.77775. That is equal to 0.778. something. So what is my answer? 0.778 or 0.785, which is closer to this? So option B is the right answer. Next one. For characteristic equation having more number of poles than zeros, the number of root locus will be equal to, if we are having more number of poles than zeros, number of locus branches will be equal to number of poles. So it is option B. Simple direct question. I hope you understand everything very clearly. That's all about this session. Please ask your doubts in comment section. I am happy to clarify all your doubts. Thank you.